Can we please bring in AJ Jakubik? As far as I'm concerned, the number one sports voice in Ottawa, the voice of everything there, but for today's purposes, the Red Blacks. What's up, AJ?
Not much. For yesterday's purpose, about 23,000 fans at Panda.
Yeah, I saw that. I saw alum of both teams going off about that. Is that the biggest crowd for a football game in Ottawa all year?
Oh, you know what? I'd have to see exactly. The last game against Montreal, they had over 23. But it's top two for sure. It's a great event, and it never disappoints. I mean, yesterday, Ottawa was up 35-24. They kicked a field goal with like a minute 10 to go, and somehow Carlton scored, got a two-point convert, got the onside kick, got into field goal range, and missed the what would have been the game-tying field goal. So it's a game that never disappoints. Unfortunately, both teams can't seem to get to be on the same level as the Lavals or the Westerns, but they do produce a lot of really good Canadian talent and CFL players around the league, and it produces one of the best atmospheres that you'll get in Canadian university sports.
Well, I saw alum of Ottawa, Darren Joseph. You probably remember. You don't probably know Darren Cobb.
Oh, yeah, of course.
Saskatchewan Rough Rider, bragging about the game and so forth. I remember, I think I was with you. I was in Ottawa. We were playing with the CFL the next day, and we drove by the stadium the day of the Panda game, and there was kids passed out in the boulevard. And I'm like, typical college football game atmosphere. Yep. Right. Hey, am I right in saying the Red Blacks have backed into the CFL playoffs? You clinched without doing anything? Am I right on that?
Well, did Saskatchewan? Because, I mean, like, when you have eight wins and a tie.
I'm not saying it's a insult. I'm just saying you've clinched, right? And you didn't play this week.
Yeah. Yeah, look, they've had a ton of injuries. They need to play better. They need to play cleaner football. They haven't played their best football the last few weeks. And the injury excuse to me is not good enough. They need to be a lot better, but I think they've done enough over the first part of the season that you can say, okay, they're a playoff team. So, they went into, they beat Winnipeg, they beat BC, they tied Saskatchewan, they beat every consequential team in the league with the exception of the Montreal Alouettes. So I think they deserve to be there. Now they need to start playing better football. They need to get healthier. Certain guys aren't getting healthy. Darius Pickett isn't coming back. He's their best player on defense. Dino Boyd, their starting left tackle, isn't coming back. That's a big loss. But hopefully Drew Brown is going to be back and ready to go just around the corner, because I think, while it's nice to have Jeremiah Masoli as the backup and a capable guy that can win some games, their best chance to win is with a healthy Drew Brown at quarterback. And he's been dealing with an ankle injury for the last few weeks, which kept him out of the lineup, and before that, he was playing, but probably shouldn't have been playing. So, I think when healthy, they're going to be as good as anyone. It feels like to me, and I know Winnipeg's playing really good football. They're probably playing better than anybody else in the Canadian Football League. But it feels to me, going into these playoffs, that whoever's playing the best in these last few weeks is going to find a way to get to the Grey Cup. And everyone, to me, has an opportunity to do some damage in the playoffs. Even a team like BC is inconsistent as they've been. They've got the talent to do it. So I wouldn't categorize them as having backed in. I think they earned their spot there, and we'll see what happens down the stretch.
Touchy. All I said was you clinched without playing. You can take it however you want. Edmonton's Mandy writes in. She says, tell AJ, nice to see him, but make your camera stop shaking. I think you're making some viewers.
No, you know what? You know what it is here? I'm literally holding it. I couldn't find it. So I've got a stand. That's really good. It's a great stand. I don't have the stand right now. I can't find my stand. I've had some buddies from Edmonton. They must have moved it. So now I'm sitting here holding it like a caveman. And so, yeah, it's the way it goes.
All I will tell Mandy is close your eyes and listen to AJ's beautiful voice, because that's what he's in this for. Anyways, Jeff, the Stamps fan, says the playoffs won't be the same this year. And that's obvious why he's saying that Calgary won't be in the playoffs for the first time in 19 years. But here's the one thing I'm dying to ask you. Our poll.
They're not going to miss Calgary. No one's going to miss the Calgary Stampeders in that dump of a stadium. How about that?
How about that?
AJ, did you not get enough sleep last night? What the hell, man? You come out just spit.
I'm an Edmonton guy. You think I'm going to say nice things about Calgary? The only nice things about Calgary. Here's two nice things about Calgary. My nieces and nephew are from there. And so it's always great to visit them. And the best thing about Calgary, you know what? Whenever Calgarians talk about Edmonton as the best thing about Calgary, it's about leaving Calgary, because they talk about the fact that the mountains are there. So you're telling me the best thing about Calgary is when you get to leave.
That's what John Frenzy used to say.
That?
John Lynch, the best part about Calgary is leaving it. So yeah, he has said that. Oh boy, choosing violence here today. But if I
like Calgary,
listen, we got a lot of.
It's one of my favorite places to go in the CFL, but that stadium needs to go.
Well, it ain't going anywhere. So we'll say deal with it. There ain't no change to that. BW in Edmonton says, I strongly agree about McMahon Stadium. Everybody, can I pull this back onto the road? Our poll question is, who should be coach of the year in the CFL? The Anis Stukas Trophy. I said Winnipeg's Mike O'Shea, Montreal's Jason Moss, Saskatchewan's Corey Mace, or other. I bet that'll rile you up too.
Well, it shouldn't be Corey Mace. Like, it's either O'Shea or Moss. I mean, right now I'd probably go with Moss. Best record in the league. I mean, Winnipeg came in every bit as strong. Look, they're playing better football now, but Montreal earned what they did by playing great football early in the season. Can they get it back? I guess we'll wait and see. But to me, it should be one of those two.
I had to pick three, and I'm like, getting
no. You know what? Good poll question. Can I give you some compliments on the poll question? It's fantastic. It made me think today, because I saw that earlier, and I honestly didn't have an answer right away. I actually had to think for a few minutes about that one.
That's what we try and do here. Shy writes in and says, the Stamps play in a real corral with a barn for dressing rooms. Listen, this is not Bash Calgary Day. We've had enough of those days. Today is not that day. Tony from George Fox Country writes that he says, by the way, Rod, love the Team Canada shirt. Hope you're not ticking off our American friends. No, they're not bitter. They're not angry. They don't care. They're like, wear what you want. Be you. That's why I love it here so much. Speaking of all this, Colin in Ottawa writes in. He says, new Sens goalie Linus Ullmark is going to use our team if we have a good year and go to a better franchise in free agency. Mark my words. Any thoughts on that?
I don't get that sense. I feel like he's doing his best to ingratiate himself into the community, and I understand why he hasn't signed yet. He moves to a new place. He wants to see how the city is for him and his family. He wants to see how the team is. But I don't get the sense that he's a one-year and done player. I do think he's going to be a big part of things if Ottawa can find a way to make a playoff spot. I like Ottawa to make a playoff spot. One of the last two spots. I don't think they're going to get one of the top three spots in the division with, you know, you got Boston, you got Toronto, you got Florida, even Tampa Bay. But I do think Ottawa can be one of the best of the rest. They brought in some of the necessary pieces when it comes to experience. You think of Nick Cousins and Mike Amadio and David Perron, who have all won Stanley Cups. But most importantly, this team needed two things. Needed a little bit more structure defensively, and certainly some better goaltending. And I think with Ullmark and Travis Green, they should be able to do that. So we'll wait and see on Ullmark. But in the meantime, I like Ottawa as a playoff team.
Well, you know what's interesting about all this, AJ? I thought it was just me lagging behind. Fans need to realize this is a different time. The fact that Ullmark isn't rushing to sign. Look what Swayman just went through in Boston, Allmark's former team. It's a different time. Don't be upset if players aren't showing loyalty to the teams, because that's where this all came from. The teams weren't showing loyalty to them ever. I mean, you seem to get that. I don't think the fans get it.
Yeah, and look, I understand when it comes to Ottawa. I mean, they've been burnt a lot. They've seen a lot of star players leave, whether it's, you know, in recent history, players like Mark Stone or Eric Karlsson, or if you go beyond that and you think of, you know, Danny Heatley wanting out, or Jason Spezza, even Daniel Alfredsson at the end of his career. But I think Ottawa's in a pretty good shape in the sense that, you know, a lot of their top players, Brady Tkachuk, Tim Stützle, Jake Sanderson, for example, have all signed here long term. So, look, not everyone's going to do the 8-year contract. And Ullmark just got here. So I think they have to be patient with things and see how things play out. And basically, you know, I'm not concerned when it comes to long term deals with a guy like Ullmark yet when he just got in the door. And let's see how things play out and go from there.
Well, you need to get creative when it comes to Canadian markets and ones that aren't perennial winners, because Toronto and Edmonton don't have a problem retaining their players. At one time, Edmonton did, but they don't anymore. You got a new rink coming. Is that attractive to players?
We think so.
What is attractive to today's players? You think so?
Yeah, we think we have a rink. I mean, we have step one of a new rink coming, so you know how that can play out. With the multiple layers, but it's a big step, because you can't get to step two, three, and four if you don't get to step one. Like Randy Ambrosi says, you can't get to 12 teams without getting to 10. So, no, it's from an Ottawa perspective, there's a lot to like here. I think the owner, Michael Andlauer, has shown that he cares about the community. He lives here, and he said all the right things, but more important, he's actually done all the right things. So I do think things are turning around here. It's going to take some time. Kind of, it's like a ship, right? You can't just turn around a franchise just like that, snap of the fingers. It's going to take some time. And right now, from the foundation up, it looks like they're building something pretty good here off the ice. And we'll see if that translates on the ice as well.
Well, it's that west end of downtown that you showed me. Is that what they're still talking about, where they're going to
build
this rink?
Yeah, the big fields that are empty. So, I mean, that's the plan at LeBreton Flats. They've sold the land to Michael Andlauer. Now they need the financing for the arena and all that. So it's, you know, there's going to be studies. They have to clean up the land. There's a lot to do. You know, when you talk to people here, there's a sense that this thing's not going to get built for, I don't know, 10 years. I feel like 5 or 6, but it's still a long process.
Absolutely. Well, listen, I'll let you go because your arms are probably tired, but I will say this. Greg in Calgary, Greg writes in on the 902. He goes, I love your stories. Your Charles Roberts story was great. Well, that was Arash's story, not mine. He told it on this show. But what I do miss, AJ, is you driving me around Ottawa or me driving you around Regina. Something always happened. Remember in Regina that day, a moose hit us. A moose hit us right in the middle of the intersection. Remember that?
I do. We saw someone carrying someone else across the intersection as well. That was interesting. Never a dull moment, but I tell you, when you travel around the Canadian Football League, there's never a bad day. Your team could be 3-15. There's never a bad day covering this league.
No, I mean, I had to give a lot of things up to come to Florida, and that was one. Traveling across Canada and these wonderful days with my friends like AJ, but you can't have everything. It's pretty awesome here, too. Buddy, thanks for this. Keep it up. Enjoying following you as always. Good luck in the playoffs.
My pleasure. Next time, I'll make sure I have this stand found.
You're good. I was fine. It was just Mandy. It was just Mandy. Thanks, AJ.
Cheers.
AJ Jakubek joining us from Ottawa. That interview should have been brought to you by McDonald's or Old Dutch, because AJ had a chip on his shoulder. I don't know why. He woke up choosing violence today.